The sprint is something that you need to design, and it's the job of the sprint master, or you in this case, to plan the activities that you're going to do before, during, and after the sprint. Let me give you an idea of what you can expect in each of these periods. First, you should know that you're going to need to do a lot of work up front. In general, you want to spend about 1 day of planning for each day of the design sprint. Now, this will feel like a lot of work, and it should be. The good news is that good planning will help you run a smooth design sprint and let you solve your design challenge quickly. Before the design sprint, you'll want to write a design brief. This will let you define your design challenge, and then it will also let you set a timeline for when you want to launch, or for when you want this deliverable, whatever it is for the design sprint, to be reviewed. Before the sprint, you'll also want to invite team members or talent to the sprint. Nadia will talk more about this later. And one of the key parts of a design sprint is user testing. You need to schedule when users will take a look at whatever you create from the design sprint. The user testing will keep you accountable, validate product ideas, and push you, and perhaps your team, towards showing users something by the end of the design sprint. Now, this might not make a whole lot of sense right now, but I guarantee you it will by the end of this lesson. Finally, before the sprint, you'll also want to schedule any lightning talks, more on this later, and you'll want to prep the slide deck that you'll use in the sprint and any room and special materials. In the next video, I'll cover the details of a design brief and how you can appropriately scope your design challenge. Here are the tasks that you'll need to do during a design sprint. If you're working alone, you won't need to do daily check-ins and daily summaries. Instead, you should keep a master list of all the tasks you need to get done so that way you can stay organized. You should also write reflections after each day so you can look back on them and get better at planning and designing the sprints, alone or with a team. One of the hardest parts about conducting a design sprint is facilitating conversation and resolving conflict among your teammates should they arise. Now, you won't really need to worry about this if you're working alone, but you will need to be the point person or appoint someone else to resolve any conflicts when they do arise. After the design sprint, you should take the lead to summarize the results and plan next steps. If you worked with a team, you'll want to send out a short survey to ask your teammates about how the design sprint went and what could go better next time. If you were working solo, then you should just reflect on what happened and how you might improve in the future. And hopefully, you'll already be working towards planning your next design sprint. All of this should feel like a lot of work. And, well, it is. Thankfully, many other companies have done design sprints before, and there's tons of great resources and documentation and short articles about how to conduct design sprints. Google Ventures, for example, has put together this awesome list of resources for you. They also have a great collection, a library of resources, that has short articles that will walk you through all of the steps needed to schedule and conduct user research interviews. These are also your usability testing interviews that you'll do at the end of a design sprint. All of these resources will be included in a reading node at the end of this lesson. They also have a great library of additional resources. In this library, you'll find a collection of short articles that will walk you through all the steps needed to schedule and conduct user research and usability interviews. The links to these articles will be provided in a reading node at the end of this lesson.